Let's go right now because I know he's super busy. Senator Ted Cruz joins us on the phone. Senator, thanks for making time to join the program. We know that you actually had, serious actual work to do in Washington, D.C. I mean, heaven forbid you go and cast some votes for the people, but we appreciate you joining us.
Well, thank you, Dana. It's always great to be with you. And I tell you, you're doing serious work every day because you're speaking out for liberty, and that is never more needed than it is today.
Well, and as are you, and I have to share with you this Washington Post headline. I thought this was mildly amusing. The headline is Ted Cruz bullied Republicans for years, and now they're standing up to him. They're angry at you because you faced off with Mitch McConnell over the XM Bank, which your arguments I thought were perfectly sound. And I wonder if Senator McConnell feels foolish now that he blocked the amendment for the defunding of Planned Parenthood.
Sure.
He blocked the Cates law. He blocked Cates law, was able to add the reauthorization of XM to that highway bill. And then the very next day, the third video drops for Planned Parenthood. What are your thoughts on this?
Well, I think that's exactly right. What Washington politicians are upset with is the conservative grassroots, because we're holding them accountable. You know, I've said many, many times the biggest divide we've got in this country, it's not between Republicans and Democrats. The biggest political divide we've got is between career politicians in Washington in both parties and the American people. And what we saw this last week was a great illustration of it, where sadly Republican leadership joined at the hip with Democratic leadership. Indeed, we've seen this week what I call the McConnell-Reed leadership team, where they're both fighting for the party of Washington. You know, Dana, one of the things people across the country are frustrating with, we were told, if only we get a Republican House of Representatives, then things will be different. We rose up by the millions in 2010, elected a Republican House, and what did we get? Not a whole lot. Then we were told the problem is the Senate. If only we get a Republican Senate, if we retire Harry Reid, then things will be different. In 2014, millions of Americans did exactly that. And what has the Republican Senate produced? Well, the first thing that happened was we got together with Democrats and passed a trillion-dollar cromnibus bill filled with pork and corporate welfare. Then the Republican majority voted to fund Obamacare, voted to fund President Obama's executive amnesty, voted to fund Planned Parenthood. And then Republican leadership jammed through the confirmation of Loretta Lynch as Attorney General. Every one of those decisions is identical to what would have happened under Harry Reid and the Democrats. It's why the grassroots are so fed up with leadership that listens to the lobbyists in Washington but doesn't listen to we the people who elected the Republican majority in the first place.
Exactly. And the power of Congress here being bypassed. I want to switch it up really quick because I know that you're very busy in the Senate today. But yesterday you challenged the president to a debate on the Iran nuclear deal and two side agreements that we were made aware of by Senator Tom Cotton do you even know the entire details of this particular deal to which you're supposed to rubber stamp for the White House?
Well, we don't know all of the details. They're keeping some of them hidden, and they're doing that very deliberately. But what we do know is that based even on the information that has been given to Congress, this deal is catastrophic. We just finished a major hearing at the Senate Armed Services Committee where a number of the enormous flaws of this came out. Number one, if this deal goes through, over $100 billion will flow to Iran. Iran is the world's leading state sponsor of terrorism. That means billions of dollars will flow directly to Hamas, to Hezbollah, to the Houthis, to radical Islamic terrorists across the globe. It means, Dana, if this deal goes through, the Obama administration, President Obama, Hillary Clinton, John Kerry, will become the world's leading financiers of radical Islamic terrorism. They will have sent billions of dollars to jihadists who will use that money to murder Americans, to murder Israelis, to murder Europeans. Now, just yesterday, President Obama in Africa took time out of his schedule to personally attack me for making that point. He said it was terrible that I made that point. He had attacked me personally, but what was very interesting, Dana? He didn't dispute the facts of it. He didn't dispute that billions of dollars would flow directly to jihadists. He didn't point to any other organization on the face of the earth that would be a larger funder of radical Islamic terrorism. And that's why, in response, I invited President Obama to debate me, not on the rhetoric that he keeps throwing around, but on the substance of this deal. And I said, I'm happy to debate him at the time and place of his choosing, anywhere in the country, anytime he likes, in the next 60 days, while Congress is reviewing this agreement. And I said, if he's unwilling to attend, if he can't be pulled off the golf course, then he can send as a proxy Secretary Kerry. We need to discuss the substance, not engage in the smoke and mirrors that is endangering the national security of our country with this catastrophic deal.
And endangering as well our allies.
Yes.
Somewhat related to the situation with Iran is the story that was making the rounds yesterday in numerous media outlets, where it was discussed how the president had given the green light to Turkey to go and bomb those factions in the Middle East that have been helpful to the Kurds, who have been standing up to ISIS. What is the story behind this, and what would you say to the White House on this?
Well, unfortunately, the Obama-Clinton-Kerry foreign policy has consistently been misguided and has weakened America's position in the world. We abandon our friends and allies with stunning regularity, whether it is the nation of Israel. This is the most hostile and antagonistic administration in history to the nation of Israel, right down to the president, vice president, and the entire cabinet boycotting Prime Minister Netanyahu's address to a joint session of Congress, but also to the Kurds. The Kurds are loyal allies. They have stood with America for decades. They are boots on the ground right now fighting ISIS. And this administration continually refuses to arm them, refuses to stand with them. Instead, it chooses to snuggle up to radical Islamic regimes who hate America, whether it is Iran, whether it is, if you look consistently at the pattern, this administration undermines allies of America and supports regimes that have deep ties to radical Islamic terrorists. So in Egypt, Hosni Mubarak, he was not a kind or good man, but had been an ally of America, and this administration stood against Mubarak, helped topple Mubarak, and as a result, the Muslim Brotherhood took over, which was profoundly antagonistic and hostile to America. Now, we have President al-Sisi, who thankfully has taken over in Egypt, is a far better ally to America, and the Obama administration, by all of their actions, would prefer the Muslim Brotherhood, the radical Islamic terrorists in charge of Egypt, rather than either Mubarak or al-Sisi. We see the same thing with Turkey and the Kurds. They consistently favor those forces that are benefiting radical Islamic terrorism at the expense of the national security of America and of our allies.
Absolutely. And we've seen this happen repeatedly over and over again. And
yes,
of course, we saw the involvement lean this way, getting up to Syria. Last quick question for you, Senator. Planned Parenthood, conservatives are leery of Republican promises when they say that they're going to defund things because
right,
the party has a history of backing down. Is Congress really going to defund Planned Parenthood?
Well, this past weekend, Mike Lee and I stood together to introduce an amendment to defund Planned Parenthood. It was an amendment on the highway bill at a 50-vote threshold where it could have passed. Republican leadership blocked it. It wasn't Harry Reid. It was Republican leadership that blocked defunding Planned Parenthood. Now, leadership has scheduled a vote on a bill to defund Planned Parenthood. What I hope is not the case is that I hope this is not simply a show vote at a 60-vote threshold that's destined to fail, so that leadership can pat all of us conservatives on the head and say, see, we gave you your vote, it lost. Now let's move back to corporate welfare and cronyism. We need to actually stand up and fight. The McConnell-Reed leadership team, leadership knows how to fight when it's actually their priorities. When it's for corporate welfare, when it's for cronyism, they know how to fight. How about we stand and fight for a priority of the real conservatives, the real grassroots? And I'll tell you, at our website, tedcruz.org, we have a national petition to defund Obamacare. I would encourage all of your listeners, go to tedcruz.org, tedcruz.org, sign our petition, and then if you want change, one of the things the last week has illustrated powerfully is we're not going to change the country from Congress, that the Washington cartel is too powerful. We've got to have a strong, proven conservative. It's the reason our campaign has raised more money than any of the 16 candidates in the race, is because 175,000 contributions have come in at tedcruz.org. We, the people, are fed up with campaign conservatives. We want a leader who you know where he'll be every day of the week, standing with the Constitution, standing for freedom, and doing what he said he would do.
Absolutely. Senator Ted Cruz, we appreciate your time today. Cannot wait to see you in action on August 6th. We'll tell you that.
Well, thank you, Dana, so much. God bless you. Thank you for standing up and speaking out each and every day.
Of course. You too. Senator Ted Cruz, everyone, and his website, tedcruz.org.